Learn more about some recent innovations in the Azure SQL space this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Pieter. Pieter, thanks so much for joining us today.
You're welcome. Yeah.
And today, we're going to be talking about some recent innovations in Azure SQL related to security, specifically TDE and Always Encrypted. But I'm not going to give away the announcement. So, Pieter, what's new?
Yeah, let's start with TDE, okay. TDE, or Transparent Data Encryption. So it's all about protecting data at rest, right? So everything that is stored on the disk is going to be encrypted, right? So before SQL Server is going to write something to the disk, we're going to encrypt it. If we want to read the encrypted information from the disk, it's going to be decrypted and uploaded, decrypted in the memory. So it's completely transparent for the application and for the user, right? Mm-hmm. Which means you don't need to have any application changes at all, right?
Awesome.
And it also means that all your backups, your transaction log files, everything that we have under the covers is automatically encrypted.
And this is on by default in Azure SQL Database?
Yes, this is on by default. You can switch it off, but we don't recommend to do that. Now, before you can do an encryption, you need to have an encryption key. Mm-hmm. And currently, on a server level, we provide two different types of key. We have the system-managed key, which is managed by us, by Microsoft. Which means the customers, they don't need to take care of anything related to key rotation and stuff like that. That's something we do. But if the customer prefers to have their own key, then they can do that. So this is what we call a customer managed key. So they can create their own key in the key vault and use that for encryption. Now, that was on the server level, right? Which means every single database that you configured on your server had to use that same key.
I see.
Now, we had a request from a lot of mainly ISVs because they want to have their keys on a database level, right? Because each customer should be able to have their own key.
Right.
So we listened to them, and we are happy to introduce that we have something new. It's called database level customer managed key. So it's independent from the server level. Mm-hmm. It's really on database level. Like I said, it was a request from a lot of ISVs. You can even configure it cross-tenant. So you can configure it in another key vault of a tenant of your customer and use it in another tenant. So that was GA last September.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Cool. I have one quick question. Customer managed key and bring your own key. Mm-hmm. Are those different things?
No, that's the same.
Same thing.
Yeah,
okay.
That's the same thing.
Got it.
Yeah, that's right. So where do you configure that?
Yeah.
Right?
Where?
In the portal, let me just quickly jump to the portal. So we have a tab called Transparent Data Encryption. And as you can see, it is enabled on the server level. So I'm here connected to a database called Demo CMK. Now, the only thing you need to do is you need to specify here, yes, I want to use database level security, CMK. You have to configure an user assigned managed identity. And the only thing you need to do is you need to select your key in the Azure Key Vault.
Awesome. Cool.
That's it.
Seems easy enough.
Yeah, that's fairly easy.
Awesome, cool. So that's TDE.
That's TDE.
What else is new?
What else is new? We have another type of encryption called Always Encrypted, which is mainly protecting your data that is in use, so sensitive information on a column level, right? So we started with Always Encrypted in 2016, but it has evolved in Always Encrypted with Secure Enclaves. Now, what we're doing is the client side is considered as trusted. Everything outside the client is considered as non-trusted. Right? So the client driver is going to encrypt that sensitive information. It's going to send it over the wire to the database engine. And then we're going to send it back, the database engine is going to fetch that information, and then we're going to send it back. Now, the database engine is going to delegate computations on encrypted data to a secure enclave. So you should see it as a black box of memory where we can securely decrypt and encrypt that sensitive information. Now, by leveraging this enclave, it allows us to do rich computation queries on encrypted columns, which we couldn't do in
the
first version.
Yeah.
So it means that we can now do like in a where clause, or larger than, smaller than. We can do order by, and we can even create an index on an encrypted column. So, lots of extra functionality by using these enclaves. And on top of that, we also can use in-place encryption, which means if you want to do an initial encryption on a column, mm-hmm. previously we had to extract all the data outside of the database, do the encryption, and then push it back in. This is not necessary anymore because now we can just use the enclave for that. So the database, or the data, sorry, stays inside the database. So
you still have to move it to the enclave, right? Or no?
Yeah, but okay. That's the engine is doing that.
Right.
So it's much faster.
Oh, okay,
so, yeah.
Cool.
The data doesn't have to be extracted outside mm-hmm. of the database. Now, talking about these enclaves, we have two types of enclaves. We have an Intel Software Guarded extension. This is really hardware that we're using under the covers called an SGX enclave. And we also have virtualization-based security, or VBS enclaves. Now, what's the difference between the two? So for SGX enclaves, the customers, they have to configure a specific database called the DC series. Mm-hmm. When they configure that, under the covers, we're going to configure a virtual machine with that specific CPU, right? So it's basically available in the vCore model, and you can go up to 40 vCores, and that is new. So previously we couldn't go that high, so we couldn't only go to 8, now up to 40 vCores.
It's a big difference.
Yeah, and it allows the customers that have high workload that needs a lot of CPU and memory, but also if they want to use the flexibility of always encrypted, they can now use these 40 vCores.
Awesome.
Yeah. On the other hand, we have the virtualization-based security, which is also new.
Oh.
Yeah. So this is generally available now, and there is no hardware dependency there. So you can
amazing.
Yeah.
Your existing databases, you can use them.
Exactly. So you can even use DTUs or vCore. You can use serverless, which is not supported in SGX. You can go up to 128 vCores, and it's available in all Azure regions. So basically, you just have to switch it on. That's it.
Just turn it on.
Yeah. And how do you do that? Let me quickly jump to the portal. So we have another tab, which is called Always Encrypted. And the only thing you need to do is you need to switch it on, right? And then it automatically says, oh, we will use a VBS enclave for you. Just hit save and you're good to go.
Cool, awesome. This has been great. I've learned a lot. I think viewers have probably learned a lot too. Is there any other new things folks should be aware of?
Yeah, there's one more thing I want to mention, and that's related to Ledger. So Ledger is all about data integrity. How can you be 100% sure that nobody has actually tampered with your data? And
right. You
also have to prove that to external parties like auditors, regulators, or even if you have a multi-party system where you need to prove, I need to prove to you that the data that we have can be fully trusted. So it's a technology that we have implemented in Azure SQL Database and SQL Server. So what we do is we're actually capturing all the transactions, mm-hmm. what is happening on a ledger table, and we're cryptographically going to link these transactions to each other, just like a blockchain, which makes your data tamper evident, and you can then verify it against whether the data, you can verify it whether the data can then be fully trusted. It's easy to use, it's inside SQL Server as well.
Awesome. Cool. Yeah. And I know for folks who hasn't seen this before, we did do an episode or maybe a couple episodes on this.
Yeah.
So definitely go check those out. We'll put a link to them in the description. Then what's new?
Yeah. What's missing, Anna? Just have a look at the slide.
We have Azure SQL Database, SQL Server. It'd be great probably if this was in Azure SQL. There we go.
Indeed.
Awesome.
So it is now available. Yeah, that was the logical step, right? So we started with Azure SQL DB. We introduced Ledger also in SQL 2022. And now it is generally available in managed instance as well. It's the same flexibility, the same functionality like in Azure SQL DB. Just configure the digest storage account. The ledger tables are there by default, so it's there.
Awesome, cool. Yeah. Well, great to hear that. Pieter, thanks so much for coming on Data Exposed. I learned a lot. I'm sure the viewers have learned a lot as well. If you're watching this video, we'll put some links in the description for you to learn more about all these capabilities. Feel free to leave us a comment and let us know what you think, what you're using today, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.